have two faculty areas. So we classify five.
Define faculty
areas as per QS as arts and humanities, engineering and technology, life sciences and medicine, natural sciences, and social sciences and management. So there are five broad areas. You have to have at least two of these five areas to qualify in the India rankings.
Okay.
But the India ranking is more focused towards reputation, definitely research from Scopus, staff with PhD as well inside. So it looks at a whole comprehensive methodology there, and I can share that with you if you'd like to do some more reading on that.
Do you look at the international accreditations also?
No, not in our India or the Asia or the world. We look at accreditations in a B school spaces.
Okay.
Yes. So you need to have one of the three accreditations which we require in a B school space. If you don't have high scores in certain areas, so if school is interested to know whether they would require an accreditation, they always write to us. Because some of the schools we have never heard of don't have scores and reputation as well. So then we require them to have at least one of the accreditations to qualify in the ranking.
So,
yeah.
Thank
you.
Yes. How do you ascertain the correctness of the data submitted by the university?
Uh-huh.
Is one.
Perfect.
And what is the guarantee that the feedback that you take from the employers is also not manipulative?
Absolutely. There's a very good two questions there. One is the data which we collect from the institution directly. Now, when we look at faculty-student ratio, this information is available in India thanks to various sources like AICT itself, which has publicly made available a lot of information. NRF has got the information available. NAC reports are available. So the possibility to fudge that data is extremely low. We go on information like reputation. Now, when we do reputation surveys, we use one of the most complex systems in the world called Qualtrics. Now, Qualtrics is a real-time AI-based survey platform which looks at where do the survey responses come from, what's the survey time like, what's the IP addresses. So if a person is able to hopefully tell an employer to vote for you, you can probably do it for one or two people, right? I mean, you kind of, if you influence a cohort of 100 employers, either you're very good or they're all in the same company. So we haven't found that so far in the surveys. The surveys have been pretty independent, and we keep monitoring them, and we remove responses from the survey which are probably have got any doubt, we've got any doubts or so. Just a word of caution here is that we have the surveys ongoing now. So if any school does have intention to participate this year, should be contacting QS almost immediately to submit the list of the academics or employers for the surveys, because this has an implication for the rest of the year. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, please.
Mine is more a perspective rather than a question. Something about ranking and accreditation. I was on both sides, so
okay.
I'm on accreditation side right now. I started with ranking. All right. I just want to tell you that we from the accreditation perspective, we treat ranking as the starting point. You come there, okay, you reach somewhere, wherever you are. You are only gauging a school's quality as its various basis, as of today, what is it? Now, accreditation starts from that process. That is SRO or whatever it is. You give your own self-regulation document. And from there, we start the accreditation process. It takes about 5 to 6 years to 7 years through mentoring process, through growth process, and so on.
Sure.
There is a lot of differentiation between these two. I think one shouldn't confuse with ranking and accreditation, because accreditation grows the institution from a point where rankings, you know, has put them on in a particular area. So increase in ranking by itself will not tell the story. That's what I want to tell you, basically. Most of the institutions feel that from rank 8, I've become 7, 6 means I've made a lot of improvement. No. That's not the perspective, because within 1 year you cannot have made that. It's not possible.
Mm-hmm.
So the question is, accreditation has a different path, ranking has a different path.
Sure, I think they complement each other as well, and I was not criticizing accreditation here, but I'm just trying to share something on the lighter side. Accreditation just does put a lot of, it does require a lot of effort, a lot of data, a lot of mentoring, so definitely the point is there. But what I'm trying to say is that there's a minimum standard which is required in there. And it's not as easy as well in the ranking as well. If you go to see them, increasing a rank has become like a dream for some institutions, whereas maintaining it has become a bigger challenge. So you know, each one of these have got different different paths for the institution as well. And I would encourage institutions to get accredited, because that would really set the standards as well and support ranking. So we work closely. We value actually the three major the Triple Crown accreditation. We value them because we believe that that sets the benchmark as well. So and you know, when we are unsure of institution's quality, we'll make sure we'll go and check whether they have either of these accreditations as well. So I'm completely agree with you on this one, definitely. Yes, please.
So what I've understood is you've said minimum two areas you have to be working in order to qualify.
In the world, Asia and India ranking,
okay.
Not the MBA. MBA is already is one area, so it's a one area ranking.
So a Indian B school can participate in the global QS ranking is what you're trying
in
to
the
say.
Global, if you're a B school
ranking.
Only,
yeah.
You
okay.
Can participate in the MBA ranking.
Okay.
And MBA ranking is made up of MBA, there's online MBA, there's executive MBA, so there are several areas in that as well. There's also an executive master's ranking we do. So if you have specialized masters, you can be ranked in there. So for that, you don't need two areas because you are a business school. But if you want to be in a comprehensive ranking where you see institutions like OP Jindal and Delhi University and IIT Delhi in there, that's a general ranking. It's a comprehensive ranking.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes, please.
This MBA school ranking, so that's just a global ranking only.
It's a global ranking. We don't do it just for India, except our IPH rating for India, which is a B school one, being produced for Indian students.
So in that case, are you ranked only the MBA school above 500, or is anyone back in the below 500 is not ranked? Is there anything?
Sorry, in below 500.
Do you appear ranked only top 500 business schools?
We have approximately, I think, close to 5. I don't know the cutoff this year. I need to check the cutoff. My bad on that. So I don't have it. But we should be looking at not more than 500 B schools or 500 MBA program. Sorry, 900 MBA programs were ranked, but I can't remember the exact number of schools. So I need to check on that one.
Okay. So you asked for the both academic, actually the employer data, probably around 300, 400 up to the contacts up to the center.
So we ask the institution, you can submit it,
yeah.
400 of academics of 400 employers, but it's not mandatory. Some of the top B schools, the top universities in the world, don't submit it because they already have got great reputation and they don't need to. But if you're in India, you have great reputation only in India, then you might want to increase your chances of people nominating you by supplying the contact. But that doesn't mean that they would vote for you, because it's a survey which goes from QS directly, and we monitor and manage the survey. Yes. Yes.
For example, if you have, there are two different MBA schools. One has, let's say, intake 120 students, and with 120 student intake to a program, you have a certain number of faculty. And this faculty would produce output. We use a QS output. Output could be in terms of research publications and activities concerning students, and ultimately placement. Now, this is one set of data you may have. Now, you may have another B school which has got, say, 600 students input. Now, for 600 students, there are larger number of faculty. So the faculty or the student output would be because of the larger number of professors who are there.
Mm-hmm.
Now the school B, which is about 600 intake, and the school A, which is about 120 intake, the absolute output would be radically different from each other. But if you look at per faculty productivity or
mm-hmm.
per student productivity, the school A, which is smaller, would be giving more
better, yes.
As compared to the school B. So do you capture this?
We look at it. So we normalize it based on by the faculty.
Uh-huh.
So the output is not the absolute number,
okay.
But it's divided by the faculty. So definitely, sometimes the people say, well, I'm a big school, you know, I should be getting better preference, but then your faculty are not publishing or are not actively being seen globally.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely, if we go, we normalize it.
That's very good. So any B school in India can actually participate?
Any B school in India can participate, yes. Absolutely.
So you don't need any of these international accreditation like
equation? I will need to check on which school. We already have a list which we released last year internally, which says that these B schools have got enough number of academic and employer votes.
Uh-huh.
So they don't need to, they don't need anything else more. But some who are not on that list, who have not got employer votes, because employer reputation is 40%, then they would need to have any, either of the triple crown accreditation.
Yeah, but you'd, I mean, you'd know that only
advanced.
After the school has approached you.
Oh, no, yes, exactly. Once you call us up and we can immediately tell you that which is, what school it is and whether you need it.
Okay.
Good, thank you.
Okay.
All right,
welcome. I suppose,
yeah, okay, that's two questions.
I suppose you say that there is a requirement of absolute 100 Scopus publication every year. It's not per faculty.
No, we don't have the minimum. So we don't have any minimum number for that. Absolutely not. Not even in our comprehensive ranking, no.
In the MBA ranking?
No, not in the MBA ranking, no. Yeah. So I'm not sure where the information, but definitely not. If you can connect with me on my email address and give me your institution name, I can help you better and let you know a little more about whether you're being featured or not, or in our radar or not. There's one more question.
I think my question was related to research and publication only.
Yes.
So do you look into the research and publication of your faculty members of B school, I mean, for your ranking purpose? If the answer is yes, what is the percentage that it gets in your rankings?
Scopus, let me just check what was the latest one. Just, research is actually a very low of 2.5%.
2.5%. Okay.
But that number was reduced because we had some new items which came in. Fine. So the methodology what we have here is employer reputation, which has got 40%. That includes both reputation and an employment rate. We have a, we look at alumni outcomes, but we look at PhD faculty as well, which is 2.5%. So pure research is just 2.5%.
Okay, this 2.5% includes research and publication by students also, or it's purely
with
academic?
Institutional affiliation.
Okay.
So it could be students publishing.
Okay.
But this is citations impact. So even if students are publishing, but they are working on getting cited, it probably pull you down.
All
because
right.
You know, you're looking at citations. Citation per faculty actually, so it shouldn't be so bad.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
Yes, okay. Just one more question.
Sure.
An extension of the question which professor asked. There is a big institution, there is a small institution. Small institution has smaller number of student faculty both, but the performance per faculty is very good. Is there a chance that this institution which is smaller will appear very high in the ranking list? Or there is a need to